Hello, my name is Niamh. I'm from the Breakthrough Maths, and welcome to this video on how to prove that tan A plus B is equal to tan A plus tan B all over 1 minus tan A tan B. Okay, so the first thing is this proof makes heavy use of the fact that tan theta is equal to sine theta over cos theta. Now, this is something you can find in your log tables, but it's also very easily provable and derivable, and I really invite you to try and do this. So if you write sine theta as opposite over hypotenuse in the sides of the right angle triangle, you do the same for tan and cos, then if you sub them into this formula, you'll be able to prove it very, very quickly that this is a true fact. And I really invite you to try this because I think whenever you derive something yourself, something goes from being a rule to a reality. So give that a go. Okay, so we're gonna make heavy use of this. Tan theta is equal to sine theta all over cos theta. Okay, so let's rewrite tan A plus B as sine A plus B over cos A plus B and see where that gets us. So we're gonna have sine A plus B all over cos A plus B. Now you can find these formulas in your log tables, and I also have proofs done of these formulas because you can see in other videos that sine A plus B is equal to sine A cos B plus cos A sine B, and cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sine A sine B. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to divide the top and the bottom of this fraction by cos A cos B. And this is perfectly allowed, it's perfectly fine. If you divide or multiply the top and the bottom of a fraction by the same thing, nothing changes, the fraction doesn't change. So we're going to do that now to simplify our expression a little bit, okay? So let's give that a go. So rewriting the top, sine A cos B plus cos A sine B, and I'm going to divide each term in the top of this fraction by cos A cos B. Now I'm doing the same to the bottom of the fraction. This is going to be all over, copying down, cos A cos B minus sine A sine B, and again dividing through by cos A cos B. Cos A cos B over cos A cos B. Okay, lovely. So let's do some simplification now. Okay, looking at our first term, we have a cos B up here, we have a cos B down there, we can cancel them. Over here we have a cos A at the top, we've got a cos A at the bottom, gone. Here we have cos A cos B all over cos A cos B, two of them cancel, leaving us with just a one. Here we have a sine A and a cos A, nothing cancels. A sine B and a cos B, nothing cancels. So let's rewrite our expression. Now we have, moving this up a little bit, hopefully. Now we have sine A over cos A plus sine B over cos B all over 1 minus sine A sine B cos A cos B. Now, what did we say before? Tan theta is equal to sine theta over cos theta. So therefore, sine A over cos A is just going to be tan A. Same thing again. Sine B over cos B is just tan B. That's all over 1 minus. Now we have sine A cos A and sine B cos B. Now this is the same thing as saying sine A cos A multiplied by sine B cos B, right? You've got two fractions multiplying together, you multiply top by top, bottom by bottom. So therefore we can write these as two separate fractions, and sine A over cos A is tan A, sine B over cos B is tan B. And you're done, and you've proved it.